So I wish I had a time-lapse camera over the last 14 years, because what you would see in the fast-forward version is you'd see a few agents turning into 200 to 300 agents, multiple states, east to west, north to south, and you would see stewardship being trained, you would see land development being trained, you would see a lot of clients, whether they're sellers or buyers, being helped.
But a little food plot might use flat.
Where we're at now, we'd have been there out of the gate. This farm would not have lasted 30 years. It wouldn't have.
And you would see the whole landscape of the recreational and agricultural real estate. You would see it changing, not just within our company, but across America. Because now people know that there are land specialists available to help them. And that kind of leads me, as I've gone from West Central Illinois, I went into Iowa, I've invested and hunted in Iowa, which is another great state, and then there was a sleeper state. I call it a sleeper state, it's probably not a sleeper state anymore, but it was the state of Kansas. And so I reached out to Todd Bigby and his partner, Tom McFarland, and when I looked at Todd's wall, in his cabin, it said everything. It actually was heart fluttering, that feeling you get where the hair on the back of your neck kind of stands up. We started talking about the last 20 years and his experience in hunting Kansas. And I was like, man, I know you're busy, but you gotta help me find something. He started sending me pictures, trail camera pictures, just about every day. And this was when the property wasn't mine, but he was showing me what the quality was like on this particular farm, which was located in Meade County, Kansas. This is too good to be true. These are giant bucks and consistent, a lot of them. So I flew into Wichita and I was all excited. We met and he picked me up. We took his truck out. And I have to say, I going through my mind, I was like, Todd, what are you thinking, man? Why would I buy a piece of cattle ground out in the middle of nowhere? It just didn't fit. Number one, it didn't fit the South where I grew up. Wasn't giant timber, you know, that big tree look. It was like you were hunting a state park. And it wasn't the Midwest where you see all the corn and soybeans and alfalfa fields and wheat fields. And you know, it's a totally different look. And I remember thinking, there is no way in the world I'm gonna buy a piece of ground out here. It's so ugly. Then we pulled up, and it was almost strange because it was like an oasis in the middle of the desert. And I was like, oh, that's why you brought me here. That's less than a year ago. This week, came to Meade County to hunt the property that he sold me for the first time, opening day. I will probably never in my life forget what I saw. I realized one of my shooters is behind me. The wind's blowing that way, by the way, which was a cause for concern.
That's a mature deer. We gotta take that buck.
So the fire drill starts.
You get turned around.
Yeah.
Come on, let's get turned around.
We pull the drapes down, we open the doors, we're shutting doors, we're putting drapes up. We're moving tripods, we're swinging chairs, we grabbed the shooting sticks. I was panicking. I didn't know what to think, except I need to get on this deer and I need to put him down.
Missed him.
No, he's right there. I missed him.
No. He's down.
Oh, that's another buck. There's another buck.
Yeah, he's much more, though.
Where'd the one go that I shot?
He's down.
Are you serious?
Yeah, you dropped him.
So he backs the footage up, and the buck that I shot is laying on the ground because I can see the footage. I have to say I was a basket case. I mean, I've hunted for a long time, but I lost it.
Now that's cool. First time on the new farm. Thank you, Todd Bigby. We found this property after about 7 years of looking. Oh my gosh.
Oh yes.
Wow. What a great afternoon. Opening day here in Meade County, Western Kansas. Big mature buck. We've got several Reconyx pictures of him. Thank goodness I looked out the back window of the Banks blind. And there he was standing there. Thank goodness he stayed standing there for about probably 5 minutes. He was just surveying the countryside, I guess. Didn't know we were in the world. Todd Bigby helped me out. We've been looking for a long time, and he started sending me trail camera pictures last year, and I knew as soon as I started seeing those pictures that that was a nice farm that I was gonna have to have. But it's out here in Western Kansas, and it doesn't look like much, but they grow them big out here. As you can see, it's not just the rack, he's a mature deer, he's huge bodied.
Rob bought a farm in Kansas, his first, with the help of Whitetail Properties land specialist Todd Bigby. And on his very first sit, he shot his biggest buck ever. It is stories like this that show how Whitetail Properties has become a billion-dollar company in a short period of time. They truly turn people's dreams into reality, and that is one reason the QDMA and now the National Deer Association has such a strong working relationship. We are both super passionate about deer and helping folks enhance their hunting opportunities.